Okay, children, we will continue with our lesson. Now we are in lesson number 2. And in this lesson, we are going to learn about animals and plants. Children, already in our previous class, we have discussed about the movements in animals. But that is nothing but how animals move from one place to another place. And also we have discussed about the food. What type of food do animals need? How they depend on plants. And we have also discussed how plants make their own food. We came to know that plants, green plants, make their own food with the help of air, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. But there are some plants which cannot make their own food. They are like mushroom. They depend on a dead and decaying matter. Right? So now, see children, open page number 14. Now we are going to learn about amazing facts. The sunflower plant eats insects to get nutrients for its growth. Insects visiting the plant get glued to the sticky fluid on the hair tips of the leaf blade. The hair then flows in on the insect. The glands on the hair tips produce digestive juices that digest the insect. So children, see here. There is one plant which that name is sundew plant. So when we look at that plant, children, it is having some hair-like structures. When insect falls on it, what happens? It tries to catch the insect. Suppose insect is somewhere here. So it tries to catch the insect with the help of the glue. Glue means like gum like structure is present on this hairy part of the plant. So with the help of this gum like structure, no, it will catch the insect. Then what it will do slowly, it will catch the insect and it will slowly eat. How it will eat? There are some digestive juices which present on this plant. That digestive juice help the plant to digest the insect. So by this method, the sundew plant eats insects. So the sundew plant is dependent on insects for its food. Next, we will discuss about brain. Animals bring oxygen through different body parts. Many animals and human beings breathe through nostrils. So children, so how animals breathe? Most of the animals breathe through their nostrils. Many see with the help of their nose. When you look at your nose, you have two open ones. So these are called as nostrils. So most of the living beings breathe with the help of their nostrils. Insects have tiny holes on their on which they breathe. So some insects. So all animals breathe the same way. No, some breathe with the help of their nose, but some animals they breathe with the help of their skin. They breathe with the help of their skin. And on the insects, what about insects? Insects have very tiny means very small holes on their body which help them to breathe air. Fish breathe through gills. So when you observe a fish, see children, when you observe a fish, it will breathe with the help of the gills. Plants breathe air through the pores on their leaves called stomata. So how plants breathe, children? If you observe a leaf, if you open the top layer of the leaf, then inside you can see some small pore-like structure. So it is called as, what do you call it, children? You call it as stomata. So this will act like a nose, means which it will help the plant to breathe air. So stomata is a part which is present on the leaf of a plant which helps the plant to breathe in air. Next, we will discuss about reproduction. So animals reproduce by giving birth to their own kind. So most of the animals give birth to their young ones. Right? They produce their own kind. Means dog give birth to a dog. It won't give birth to cat. Did you see any man? No. So they give birth dog give birth to one more dog. If you take example of a lion, it will give birth to one more lion. Like that, they produce their own kind. Some animals are produced by laying eggs. So children, some give direct birth to their animals, but some lay eggs to give birth to their ones. Plants produce seeds. Later seeds grow into same plant. So animals, some lay eggs, some they give direct birth. But what about plants? Plants lay seeds. What they do? They lay with the help of the seeds. See children, when you observe a fruit, it will have seeds. Some vegetables, they also have seeds. So if you take seeds and sow them in the soil, you know, that seed goes into grows into a small plant first, then it will grow into a big plant, and again it will give with the same variety of fruits or